You know, when we enter into halls like this, our answers change automatically. We know what we're supposed to answer here. You know why? The truth is because each soul is innately very knowledgeful. Wisdom is the quality of every soul. And that's why each one of us knows the truth. Each one of us knows what is right. Each one of us knows where the solution lies. And yet for some reason, when we go out, we're thinking different. So, you agree? You're not going to wait for the world to become perfect? Sure? And world means, does not mean the planet. World means my world now. My world. Let's take some equations. If I'm healthy, then I will be happy. Or if I'm happy, then I will be healthy. It can be the other way around also. If I'm healthy, then I'm happy. No? Because when you go out, then many of us are going to say, if my health is fine, then I will be happy. But with all these aches and pains in the body, how can I be happy? So the equation goes the other way around. And so do I wait for the body to be healthy so that I can be happy? So if I'm healthy, then I will be happy, or if I'm happy, then I will be healthy. If I'm happy, then I will be healthy. And if I'm not healthy, then what is the reason? Then I'm not happy. If I have beautiful relationships and people are nice to me, then I will be happy. Or if I am happy, then I will have beautiful relationships and people will be nice to me. So finally, at the end of the day, people say, ye kya baat hai, ghuma fira ke, hum wapis kiske paas aa jate hain, apne paas hi aa jate hain. The responsibility comes back to me. But that's the truth. That's the truth. And when we realize that, then creating a beautiful world becomes very, very simple. And if we don't go to the right equation, then try however hard. Try however hard, we will not be able to create a beautiful world because we are not going to the seed. One is the seed of life and the rest is the tree of life. Now just come to yourself, forget the planet, just come to your world. Your mind, that means the soul, your mind, the creator of every thought and feeling is the seed of your life. From this seed gets created the tree of your life. What is there in the tree of our life? What's there in the tree of our life? Our work, our relationships, our family responsibilities, our social work, our other professional, everything is in the tree of our life. But who is doing all this, who is nourishing this tree is the seed. Who is doing all my work? My mind. Who's creating the health of the body? My mind. Who's creating my relationships? My mind. Who's going and doing social work? My mind. So who's the seed? Here. What's the tree? The rest of my life. Now, throughout the day, instead of watering the seed, we are going and washing every tree and every fruit of the tree. Isko bhi khush karo, isko bhi khush karo, isko bhi khush karo, isko bhi khush karo. Make this one happy, make this perfect, make this clean, make this neat, make this beautiful. And by the time we wash this side of the tree and we come to this side, now again this side is not happy. So people say, if I take care of my work, then my family has a problem. If I spend time with my family, then my work has a problem. How am I supposed to manage my work and my life? Because we're trying to manage the tree. And then if I take care of both, then my health gets affected because I'm not taking care of my health. So somewhere something is missing because I don't have time for everything. Because in one day, it's impossible to take care of the entire tree. But that happened because we were trying to take care of the tree. Just one day go to the garden and try to take care of the tree.
what will happen? More time, more effort, and less result. And how much time does it take to water the seed? How much time does it take to water the seed? Water the seed will take care of the tree. But if I don't water the seed and I keep working hard on the tree, then I work hard, I work tirelessly, I work day and night, and yet at the end of the day, the fruit of my tree seems to be. So I have everything, but yet I'm not happy, yet I'm not contented, yet there's not harmony in my relationships because I was working hard on the tree. We don't need to work so hard in life. Life is not meant to be a struggle. आजकल किसी से पूछो क्या हाल चाल है तो क्या आंसर मिलता है हाउ आर यू पहली बात तो सबको मिलते हैं तो हाय हाय करते रहते हैं हाय 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 करते स्पिरिचुअलिटी सेज कभी भी हाय हाय नहीं करना चाहिए किसी को एनी वर्ड रिपीटेड विल बिकम अ रियलिटी ऑफ लाइफ सो बिकॉज वी कट शॉर्ट आवर ग्रीटिंग एंड वी केप्ट ऑन सेइंग सुबह से रात तक हाय 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 लाइफ ही हाय 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 बन गई फिर तो आज से हाय हाय नहीं बोलना बिल्कुल भी परमात्मा कहते हैं वाह वाह बोलना चाहिए वाह मेरी जीवन वाह मेरा भाग्य वाह लोग वाह रिलेशनशिप्स वाह वाह बोलना चाहिए वॉट इज द क्वालिटी ऑफ माई सीड is what is going to create the quality of my tree. And if anyone is going to say, I don't have time to water the seed, because I'm too busy, you ask someone, why you don't have time to water the seed? Because I'm too busy taking care of the tree. Then we need to ask ourselves, how intelligent is that? And then in spite of doing all that, we have so many issues today to address in the tree. Because if the seed was not healthy, the tree cannot be healthy. The fruits are there, but they are not tasty. We have everything in life today, everything. And yet, there was a time in life where the tree was simpler. But the seed was healthy, right? Homes were small, but families seemed happier. Which does not mean that big homes is not families happier. It's just that when we worked so hard to achieve outside, we forgot to take care of the seed. And spirituality means water the seed. And if we water the seed, we will work throughout the day, we will take care of all our responsibilities, but it will happen in a very, very natural and effortless way. It will not be a struggle. Koi puche kya hal chal hai, to ye nahi bolna, chal raha hai. Beet gai, ek aur din. Life is not supposed to be, haan, chal raha hai. Life is supposed to be. परमात्मा कहते हैं कोई पूछे क्या हाल चाल है तो बोलो खुशहाल है फरिश्तों जैसी चाल है सेना सुंदर बोलो आप एक बार क्या हाल चाल है खुशहाल है और फरिश्तों जैसी चाल बोल के चेहरे खिल गए अभी आप बोलो हाय हाय तो देखो चेहरा कैसा हो जाएगा दैट्स व्हाई एवरी वर्ड इज इम्पोर्टेंट Every word is important, which means every thought is important. If I create a low vibration thought, then I create a low vibration word, then I manifest a low vibration life. If I create the highest vibration thought, then I bring it out into the highest vibration word, then I manifest a high vibration life. It's all about what I create. So when we talk about the word harmony in life, so where do I need that harmony to be? Where do I need harmony to be? So I want harmony in the tree. So where do I need the harmony to be? Harmony means energy is flowing smoothly. Conflict means we get entangled. Harmony means there is smoothness. Where do I need that harmony to be? Not in the tree. We need that harmony to be in the seed. Here. If there's harmony here, there's silence here, there's cleanliness here, there's purity here, the body, the relationship, the world, everything will be beautiful. Our every thought impacts four parts of our life. Just check this and you'll never create a wrong thought. Our every thought, and we create thousands of thoughts in a day, our every thought first influences how I feel. As will be my thought, so will be my feeling. Sometimes we say, I'm feeling very low today. You will not be able to change the feeling. You will have to rewind and check, what have I been thinking? And I will need to change my thought, only then my feeling will change, because the feeling is the second stage. I cannot shift from a low feeling to a high feeling unless I change my thought. Ye alag baat hai ki I can eat something and drink something and think that I can shift from a low feeling to a high feeling. But actually when I consume anything like this, I'm shifting from a low feeling to a lower feeling. Nothing else. Because I've consumed something of a lower vibration. Even if it's a momentary distraction, if I have consumed a lower vibration, it cannot shift me to a higher vibration. Everything is energy. So my every thought influences how I feel. Second, my every thought radiates to every cell of my body. So my every thought creates my body. So my health is a manifestation of my thinking. Third, my every thought reaches to people about who I am thinking. This is something we're not taking care of. We are taking care of how we talk to people. We are taking care of how we behave with people. We're not taking care of how we think about people. Energy does not stay blocked here. So if I just create a thought for her right now, it's going to go there. So your thought reaches the other person faster than your message reaches them on the phone. So be careful what you think. Be careful what you think about people. And if you want harmony in your relationship with them, don't need to do anything about changing them. You only need to change how you are thinking about them. So my third level is my thoughts create my relationships. And fourth, my thoughts radiate into the world. The world can be your house. The world can be your office. The world can be your city. The world can be your country. Just go from one city to another. The vibration is different. Do you feel that? Do you feel the vibration of your city is different from some other cities? Yes? How many feel that? And what's the vibration of your city? It's different, but what different? What's the vibration of your city? What's the vibration of your city? Because when you come to another city, people will say, so how do you like our city? But liking the city is not about what the city has created in the outer world. The city is about the vibration of that city. It's like a house. You go to someone's house, it's perfect in what it is. But sometimes the vibration of the house is very heavy. How many can make out vibration of houses? Can make out, no? You enter into somebody's house, there's a lot of calm and tranquility. Enter into someone's house, there is a very heavy feeling. Who creates that vibration of the house? Who's creating the vibration of the house? The people's minds living in that house. So whether it's that house, whether it's the city, whether it's the country, whether it's the world, we are just expanding that effect to a bigger level. But it's getting created by how we think. So our thoughts are not about us. Our thoughts are about what the world has become. And so if we want to change anything in the world, it cannot be changed in the world. And the reason why the world is struggling to create a result is because they're trying to create that result in the world. You cannot create the result in the world. It's as good as wanting to change the vibrations of the house. How will you change the vibrations of the house? If somebody walks into your house and says, the vibrations of your house are very heavy, there's a lot of pain and it's not very comfortable in your house, please change the vibrations of your house. What will you have to do? How will you change? The air freshener is not going to do that. You know, when someone's going to come to our house, we go, that air freshener is here. And that's what brother said in the beginning, that even if we want to purify the air, it will first need to begin with us. So I want for myself a peaceful mind, a healthy body, beautiful relationships, a happy home, a very comfortable workplace, a beautiful city, and a very, 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 very beautiful world. It's very simple. It's very simple. I only need to create every thought the right thought. Simple? 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 And so we'll do it from today? I can finish here then. It's actually done. We really don't need to do anything after that. It's that simple. But for that, what do we need to do is, throughout the day, be aware that I am creating this thought. Today we shifted from a conscious way of living, understanding that I am creating this thought, we shifted to a way of living which said, I'm feeling like this because of them. And we blamed people for how we were feeling and thinking. And so whenever you find yourself a little low, you have someone to put the finger on, or something to put the finger on. And we say, I'm feeling like this because of them. Which means we're going the other way around and we're saying the world is not nice and so I'm not thinking right. And the more I'm going to do that, I will not think right. And the more I don't think right, the more the world will not be right. And this Kali Yuga got stronger and stronger and stronger. So the first thing we need to finish, if we want to create an energy of harmony, the first thing, finish forever, never ever blame anyone or anything for what we are feeling. Never ever blame anyone or anything for what you are feeling here. Ready? Can you think of anyone that you have been blaming for how you're feeling? And if you found the name, raise your hand. They could be sitting on the next chair for all you know. And we're like, how am I going to raise my hand? They're sitting right here. And remember, if you think of them, they can catch your vibration. So it's not about what you speak and do. Whatever's on your mind is going to be there. Every time people were not our way, or situation was not our way, or sometimes we started saying life is not my way, which means nothing is going my way. Every time something was not my way, I allowed my thinking also to not be my way. So the outside was not my way, and then the inside was also not my way. But when the inside is not my way, the inside impacts the outside.